He was the millionaire with a heart of gold, a titan of the British fashion scene who spent as much time giving money away as he did amassing it. Gerald Weisfeld, who has died aged 79, was the financial brains behind What Every Woman Wants, the chain that rose from a single store in Glasgow's Argyle Street to become a fixture of the UK high street in the 1970s and 80s. His enthusiastic staff would sing the company song as they opened up each morning. Comedy legend Billy Connolly even turned up in a horse and cart to declare one store open. Television adverts were recorded to the tune of Status Quo's hit Whatever You Want. Yet behind all the showbiz razzmatazz lay a laser-like commercial brain which could spot a business opportunity in a trendy tank top, and have it on sale in his stores within hours. Rara skirts were on sale for just £1 a time, with bobby socks for 50p. Mr. Weisfeld's ability to spot a bargain was shared with thousands, if not millions, of young women who were able to afford London fashion at bargain basement prices. Truly, he knew what every woman wants. His Midas touch was rewarded in 1990 when he and his wife Vera sold the Whatevery's business for £50 million, believed to be the highest amount ever paid for a Scottish fashion house. And within hours of receiving the big check, Mr. Weisfeld was writing another one, for £10 million to be used for charitable causes at home and abroad. He funded an emergency welfare mission to the former Yugoslavia in 1994. Taking food by convoy and setting up a kitchen for refugees in war-torn Bosnia. Children's homes were established in Romania, offering refuge to children rejected by society because they were suffering from AIDS. Mr. Weisfeld died on Sunday night, after a long battle against Alzheimer's disease. He was cared for at the Bothwell Castle Care Home and at Summerley Care Home in Coatbridge, both Lanarkshire. His wife said yesterday, "My family's hearts have been broken over the last 8 years, witnessing Mr. Weisfeld's mind and body being taken over completely by this cruel and wicked disease. For all his abilities, he could do nothing to prevent it. I would like to thank the care home staff who looked after him so well, particularly Laurie, who would come in on her day off to make sure he was looking his best. The family were all with him on Sunday night when he passed, including Laurie." Last year, the historic building on Argyle Street that housed their first store was demolished. The Category B listed building, which was a popular department store, will be replaced by an office block. The building, which dated from about 1870, housed the flagship store for What Every Woman Wants, which had 130 shops around the UK at its peak. But it was closed in 2003 following a period of administration. In September, US Fin for more on this story, visit the news article link.